everyone and welcome to the amazing review of the Honda Amaze. I hope you all are doing well. So special thanks to Prime Honda Delhi for providing us this car for the review. And it goes without saying, for best deals in Delhi, you can visit the Prime Honda dealerships. And don't worry about your safety because they are following all the guidelines issued by the government. And if you are in defense, Prime Honda also deals with CSD canteens. So it is a good deal for you as well. So before we begin with the review, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell so you never miss an update from Rev Explorers. You can also go ahead and check out our social media pages on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter and follow us there. Now let's begin with the amazing review of the Honda Amaze. Let's begin with the key of the car. So the remote has three buttons. The first one is lock, the second one is unlock, and the third one is hold to unlock the boot. And that's it, the standard Honda key. So this one is the 1.2 liter petrol CVT. The Honda Amaze is offered in four variants and two engines with two transmissions. So the first engine is 1.2 liter petrol, which is this one. The other one is 1.5 liter diesel. And both of them get manual transmission as well as CVT transmission. The difference between the manual transmission is 1.2 liter petrol gets 5-speed manual transmission and the diesel gets 6-speed manual transmission. And the Honda Amaze is available in 5 different colors. So 4 variants and 5 colors. You can pick any. So in the front, the Honda Amaze gets the signature Honda wing face chrome grille, which looks really good on this car. I mean, this one looks very aggressive. The older generation was not so aggressive. This facelift was done in 2019 and it has been same ever since. Now it gets a BS6 compliant engine. So you have the halogen headlights with LED position lights, halogen turn indicators and halogen fog lamps. Honda has given Amaze a very sporty front bumper, which looks really good. The Honda Amaze also gets this prominent shoulder line which runs from the headlamps to the tail lights, and it looks really good. It makes the car feel more premium. Now on this car you do not get chrome handles, that is very good. And you get request sensor on both the front doors. With that you get the power foldable ORVMs with LED turn indicators. Now on the Honda Amaze you get 15 inch alloy wheels, and these are not diamond cut alloy wheels, these are multi-spoke alloy wheels with 175 by 65 section MRF tires mounted on it, and these are radial tires. The overall ground clearance of the car is 170 mm, which is higher than the Honda City. I think Honda City should also get 170 or 180 mm so that it does not bump on Indian roads. At the rear you get halogen tail light, halogen turn indicator and halogen reverse indicator. Along with that, Amaze gets reverse parking camera. Now it is not a multi-angle camera like in the Honda City and the WRV, it is a normal camera with 4 reverse parking sensors. And just like the front bumper, the rear bumper also gets this mini skirting for an added sporty design. The car gets shark fin antenna and rear defoggers. Now let's check out the boot. This is a big enough boot. It is 420 liters and it can cater to your weekend getaway or your family holidays. Inside the boot you have this boot light over here. Now let's get inside the car. One thing I have noticed about all the Honda cars is that whether it is the City, WRV or the Amaze, the headroom is almost the same. In fact, the knee room is also the same. I don't know how they do it, but it is. This seat has been pushed all the way back. So if you are 6+, you might have to just go like this. But if you are 5'9 or 5'10, you can easily sit in this car. Now this seat can seat 3, but then you have this cup holder and the armrest in the middle, which will be slightly uncomfortable for someone sitting in the center. However, the hump is not that big. It is just 1 or 2 inches. So it won't be a problem over here. And you do not get rear AC vents. Along with that, in the rear seat, you have this power outlet, 12 volt power outlet, and this center reading lamp for all the 4 or 5 passengers. I don't know why, but I feel that this seat is slightly hard. The back comfort is okay, but it is not that great. And these are flat seats, so you don't get ample amount of thigh support. Along with that, there are only 2 headrests and they are not at all adjustable. So the door is in dual tone, so you have this beige finish that is 80% of beige finish and 20% of this black finish with matte silver handlebars, and all four windows are power windows. Although they are not one touch up and one touch down windows, they are just normal power windows. You have sufficient amount of space to keep 1 liter bottle with some duster or something, and four speakers on all the four doors. Now let's get into the driver's seat. And just like the rear door, the front door is also 80% beige and 20% black. Although you have this piano black treatment on this one and the silver matte handlebar. Now over here you get master control for all the windows, and the driver side window is one touch up and one touch down. Along with that you have the lock unlock buttons and the ORVM controls. Below that is space for 1 liter bottle, an umbrella, as well as your map, and a speaker on the front door as well. Now coming to the main dashboard, just like the doors, the dashboard is also treated in two colors, black and beige. However, on the dashboard, black is 60%, beige is just 40%. So it is a hard plastic dashboard, which is okay because all the competition has it. Now you do get these piano treatments on the dashboard and this satin accents around the AC vents. On the right hand side, you have the engine start stop button and the headlight adjustment button. Now coming to the steering wheel. So the steering wheel of Honda Amaze is pretty simple. There is no cruise control on it, only the controls for your infotainment display, that is volume up, down, next previous, source, call pickup, drop, and voice assistant. You do get paddle shifters now, and they are good to have. Now behind the steering wheel on the right hand side, you have the headlight controls with the turn indicator controls. Now this car does not get automatic headlights. In fact, it does not get LED headlights also. Honda, are you listening? You need to upgrade this. In the center is the Honda logo, the horn, and SRS airbags. On the left side is the wiper controls. So no news for a rain sensing wiper also. Coming to the main instrument cluster, you have two analog meters, the tachometer and the speedometer. In the center is a small MID which shows your fuel gauge, your outside temperature, the gear you are in. The gear position is only for the automatics, not for the manual. On the left hand side is the instantaneous fuel efficiency and the trip meter and the odometer. Coming to the center console, you have the AC vents, and then you have the 7-inch infotainment display with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. Let's check out how it sounds. Below this infotainment display is the automatic AC control. Now below this AC controls are the 12 volt power socket with two USB sockets, one for Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, the other one is just for normal charging. Then you have space to keep your phone, the cup holders, and this is your CVT, currently in parking, but you do get drive and sports mode. With that, there is this manual handbrake and an armrest with a small storage. This is just for namesake. The glove box is treated in beige and there is good amount of space to keep your gloves. Just kidding, it is a decently sized glove box. Over here on the top, you have the vanity mirror for the co-passenger, a normal IRVM, and then there is this sun visor over here with not even a toll receipt holder. I think Honda needs to improve many things in this car. Now you get cruise control in the manual transmission and not in the automatic transmission. I don't know why. I think Honda will be able to answer. Honda, if you are listening, could you please answer it in the comment section below? These seats are bucket style, so you do not slip off, with good amount of back support and decent amount of thigh support. In terms of safety, this car gets only 2 airbags as standard in all the variants. I think the top variant should get 4 because at least the curtain airbag should be there. With that, you have ABS with EBD and auto unlock on impact. And now it's time to take the Amaze on an amazing drive. Let's see how it performs. Is very spacious. In fact, it is the biggest in this segment, and this car has been built keeping in mind the ride quality of the passengers, hence it is comfortable, although it does have slightly stiff seats for the rear passenger. The good thing is that Honda changed many things on the Amaze with the facelift edition. The one I am driving right now is a 1.2 liter naturally aspirated CVT engine And fortunately, I have also driven the manual variant of this car. With the BS6 compliance, the motor has become even more refined, and Honda has always been known for their petrol engines. Though it comes to me as a surprise that Honda has still not launched the 1-liter turbo engines in India because their Korean competition has. This engine's delivery is also good. In fact, the performance figures for both petrol and diesel are now better in the BS6 variant. Plus, the car has lost significant amount of weight and hence it is light, helping better the power to weight ratio. The engine power delivery is very linear. You might feel a good pull in the mid-range, somewhere above 3000 RPM, but it exhausts out in the top. The petrol car maxes out at 6500 RPM and the diesel one maxes out at 4500. The concern at the top is that the NVH level goes up. The motor is very calm and silent up till the mid-range, however gets very vocal in the top. In fact, you can feel slight vibrations on the steering, pedals and the gear lever. So it is more of a family sedan than a sports sedan. Although you do get sports mode and it is good when driving for fun. But other than that, it's better to use and drive because it delivers better fuel efficiency. The only thing I feel is that the car revs out really quickly, especially in the diesel variant. Now this one is a CVT. But you do get manual transmission and I have driven it, so I can tell you that the gear shifts are absolute delight. They are very soft and light, plus the clutch is also light. However, the travel is slightly on a longer side. And when you go for automatic in Amaze, you get a CVT, which is a way better option than the AMT in Dzire. The steering is also good, lacks slight feedback, but it is very easy and light to operate at slow speeds, or I can say while using in the cities. The center head play is also not much, so you don't have to worry about anything. The car is easy to maneuver and has a decent turning radius. While at high speed, the steering is rock steady, so it doesn't really cause any trouble. It is very stable. The brakes on Amaze are fantastic. Such powerful bite, the ABS with EBD works flawlessly, the car is very well in control while braking. In fact, if you pound hard, they are really scary. Such good bite and feedback inspires so much confidence and makes the car reliable, trustable and safe. The Honda Amaze has a softly sprung suspension setup, which definitely enhances the ride quality and car absorbs the bumps very easily. It is very comfortable to ride around the cities. However, the sharp bumps at high speeds still carry and they really shake the complete car. But overall, it does a great job in keeping the driving experience good. I like Honda's engine, Honda's reliability, but I feel Honda needs to up the game in this segment. They definitely have a better build quality than the Maruti Suzuki Dzire, which is the highest selling car in this segment. In fact, the engine is also way better. But still, they miss out on some features and engine options that Hyundai offers in their Aura. This is a good city use family sedan with few missing features. Our drive with the Honda Amaze has come to an end, and all I can say is that Honda needs to improve the interiors for this car. I mean, there are multiple upgrades that the competition has already brought in, but all in all, it is a good car because it gets the Honda engine, which is very reliable. So if you like this car, you can get it too, starting from 8.5 lakhs all the way up to 11 lakhs. So the choice is yours. You have the diesel, petrol variants, you have the manual, automatic. With that said, our review has come to an end. I hope you did like this video. Do give it a thumbs up and share it with your family and friends. If you are new to our channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell so you never miss an update from Rev Explorers. You can also go ahead and check out our Instagram, Facebook and Twitter pages and follow us there as well. We are present by the same name, that is Rev Explorers. Last but not the least, if you have any doubts or any queries, leave it in the comment section below or just get in touch with us on our social media pages. We'll see you again in the next video. Till that time, stay home and stay safe. Bye-bye.